it's just a team of Kayla and I, so it's been tough. Hey guys, we are back with another video. We got a really fun request from one of our subscribers. They said in a note with their order that they wanted us to film us packaging their order. So that's what we're going to be doing today. So hope you guys are interested in that.
This particular order I feel like would be a good one to film. It's on the larger side. There's multiple different products in there. So it'd be a good way to just show everyone how to kind of put this large order together.
Yeah, putting together a large retail order that's not wholesale. So see how we do it.
I made all of these bath bombs yesterday. In this section, there were French lavender bath bombs, but Kale has just wrapped them all. But here are our Georgian Bay bath bombs. Here are our Grapefruit Sunrise bath bombs, and here are our Cherry Bomb bath bombs. They're all kind of painted the same way. They all have gold on them. I just realized that, Kale, that they all have gold. Come on, guys, play nice. Play nice.
Get the kitty. Get the kitty. Get the kitty.
When two siblings get caught fighting. So here is our subscriber's order. Her name is Andrea. Thank you so much, Andrea, for your order. We appreciate so much when you guys send us notes along with your order, telling us that you watch our videos and that you're big fans of us. We love that. But Andrea took it a step further and requested that we actually pack her order on camera and post a video on it. So that's what we're going to do for her. Thank you so much again. We love your support. And as you can see, she definitely put in a big order. She ordered a variety of soaps, a variety of bath bombs, and some lip balms. So what's the first step when we get a
first
big
step,
order like that?
We're gonna go upstairs and pick the soap that she has for her order.
So this has been a few weeks now into this new curing system, and I must say, sorry, that's Dempsey crying because she's not allowed in this room and she wants inside. Sorry, Dempsey, you're not allowed. This curing system, after a few weeks of using it, has been amazing. I love it, worth every penny. I actually wanna buy more because I run out of space a lot with these guys. Here is our orange patchouli and rosemary mint soaps that are now in that really nice new bar shape. I really like it. And I wanted to quickly talk about these multi-pore soaps that Kale made a couple days ago. I mentioned it in the video but cut it during my editing process, but these beautiful botanicals, which are currently blue, red, cornflower petals, and there's some yellow in there as well. This will eventually turn brown over time. I think a few of you have pointed that out in the comments, which is great. Thank you guys so much for filling in those gaps of information when I don't mention them. That's something to keep in mind with melt and pour, is that all botanicals used in melt and pour soap will turn brown over time. So by the time these get to whoever orders my birthday bundle, these botanicals will likely not be this color. So that's just an FYI for that. And I did want to give an update about the middle of the soap and how I thought it would start to fade to yellow. The good news is it's staying pretty vibrant, so that's great. When I look at these guys, they still look just as pink and purple as when I first cut them, so that's good news. I'll keep updating you guys on the situation.
So all the soap's in there, and we just want to point out this size. This is the one that Andrea will be getting with our larger mold.
We are transitioning to the tall and skinny shape. So anyone that orders right now that has bought a soap that we have a squat or square shape for, you might get it in the tall and skinny form. So that's a little bit of a bonus for our customers. And really excited to fully transition over everything. I've been taking pictures of our soap as I'm making them, getting the website ready for that launch, and that should be coming in the next few days. So excited for you guys to get your hands on these soaps, but we've already been shipping a few of them out for the ones that have already fully cured, the Lemon Shandy soap being one of them. And then soon we are launching our Georgian Bay soap, which we also did in this taller, skinnier bar shape. So that's exciting.
So I have started picking the bath bombs that Andrea ordered. They're right down here, and I just need a Georgian Bay and a Lavender Fields bath bomb now.
Yep.
And so those are all the ones that she ordered there.
We store our bath bombs down in the basement so that they don't have any sunlight touching them whatsoever. And our basement is a cool, dry place. which is great because bath bombs also hate humidity. And as the seasons change and the weather becomes more humid, this is the best place for them. And yeah, as you can see, they're very vibrant and they keep their color up until we sell them.
Now, let's go get our lip balms.
Yeah. It's kind of a mess right now, but we will figure out a better system at some point.
So I have Andrea's lip balms here, and we still have one more, which I made last night. So I still need to pull that out of the molds where they're drying and shave those down. We'll print off the labels for them and get that last one in probably on the end, the latter side of this video.
Yeah, so we did a rebrand recently, and here are the new lip balm labels. You can see that it's more simplistic. We have the actual product itself that's in prominence, and then the flavor is secondary, and our logo is much bigger. So this is the new labels, and this is what we were doing before, where we were highlighting the flavor and our logo was much smaller. And we think that it's such a great change. We feel that these lip balms are a lot chicer. They're something that our target customer will be more attracted to. So I think it's great. But as we transition over again, if you make an order, your label might look like this, or it might look like this, which is why we're not updating the pictures right now. We're just going through a transition phase until we get rid of all of these labels, and we'll be able to do that fully.
So the next step that we are going to do is wrap all of those soaps in our national shrink wrap system. We use biodegradable shrink wrap when we shrink wrap all of our orders. And also when we sell online, we have two options for our customers. They can request to get their soap either wrapped, and by wrapped, it will be wrapped in that biodegradable shrink wrap, or they can select naked. And if they do select naked, we protect them with just a paper sleeve.
We used to use coffee filters, but this paper sleeve is easier.
We should show them the new sleeves.
Here.
Yes, pass me the one.
Here's the new paper sleeve.
So we use the new coffee filters, but now we got these sleeves from Staples, I think it was, Kale?
Yes, those were Staples, yep.
And our new tall and skinny shape fits into these perfectly. So you just put the soap in there. Bam, you have a soap that's protected during transit, and it looks so cute.
Did you pull this from this box?
Is this part of yours? No, this is always in there,
okay.
Yeah.
I wonder what that's there for. Random. No, it's there for a different order. I just haven't wrapped it yet.
So Andrea's order was such a huge variety of soaps, and we really appreciate that. It looks so colorful when you're shrink wrapping it.
Yeah, this is really fun knowing this is all one order here.
Yeah.
A lot of times when I'm doing this, I'll combine, you know, 3, 4, 5 different orders when I do like these 3 columns of 3. But these are all going to the same place.
Yeah. And this shrink wrap machine makes wrapping soaps so easy. I love this machine so much. I've had it now for over 2 years and have not regretted getting it one single bit. Probably
and
keep using it for a while.
Be needing to change the roll out here pretty soon.
Yes. We have our next roll ready over here.
Thanks, Art.
Yeah, thank you, Art. Art is the owner of the National Shrink Wrap Company, and he's awesome. Great guy.
I remember when I first started doing this, I was so bad at it. Like, that's the only thing I can just repeat myself when saying is just, you know, always keep the piece moving just so the heat isn't in one spot, like you don't even want it in one spot for like a quarter of a second. So just always keep it moving.
Muscle memory will make it easier with time, but definitely it's one of those things that if you have to do it again and again and again to get good at getting holes at the beginning is normal.
Yeah.
Learn holes not to stress out too much about that.
Holes are good.
Yeah,
I gotta look. There may be holes in there. I gotta double check though.
Kale's a master at the snow.
Look at this label on the tall and skinny bar. How cool does this look? I'm still deciding whether or not I want this size label on this size bar, but I think I'll stick with it for a bit. I still need to get it up on the site. I'm so behind on getting things up on the site. It's just a team of Kayla and I, so it's been tough. One of the things that I definitely want to hire, if we ever get to that point, is someone that just manages our website 100% and is able to restock things as they're available, put things as sold out when they're not available. Getting pictures up that are updated. It's just a big mess. It's one of the things that I'm so bad at. Oh no, I think I put the wrong label on the wrong soap. Oh no, I didn't. Okay, perfect. We're good. I honestly can't multitask sometimes. I have to stay focused on things. I'm glad I noticed that before I stuck the label on there.
So moving over to lip balms now that we have soap all packed. We have the three ready to go, but I made some of these caramel lip balms last night. Jerrica has since made a new label for the caramel ones. So we have these printed out, 12 on a sheet. When I put these on here, there's a little tab that we make sure. I don't know if you want to zoom in there, Jerrica. Make sure the tab there is on the lid. That just proves that it hasn't been tampered with once it's rolled on. And then we just roll it around here and we put that on the tube there. We have a nice creamy caramel lip balm. So we are putting the label around these bath bombs here now. This is a grapefruit sunrise. And Andrea ordered, seven bath bombs.
Hi, we're back. We had to cut really abruptly yesterday because our camera battery died, but we are now back the next day and we are going to resume where we left off. And where was that, Kale? Do you remember?
Yep, such is the life. So we're back here the next day. And so we have all of our soap wrapped in here. I have since double checked all the soap, double checked the bath bombs for what scents we have. And I'm just going to finish off here with the
lip balms.
And for the lip balms, we have a watermelon burst. Yep, we have a creamy caramel, which I recently made. We have a peaches and cream. Getting those in there, Jerrica?
Yeah.
And then we have our orange mango spice.
Yeah, see, these are the old labels and these are our new labels.
So we're gonna put in frill on top of these bath bombs and then on top of the soap over here to give them some protection. And then for the last, for this last layer, we like to put a layer of filler paper, butcher paper. What's this official word of this? Craft paper?
I think it's called craft paper. Butcher paper. And for those wondering, what is the size box we've got here?
This is a 12 by 9 by 4.
Yes, so we get boxes of all different sizes, and our supplier of the boxes is Staples, mainly. Sometimes we get them from Uline too, though.
So we got our Canada Post label here. I've cut it in half. The other side comes out as a receipt. I really like using these Canada Post labels when shipping to the States because the packing list is right here on the label. I don't have to print a separate packing list and attach it on there. So if it's 4 items or less, doesn't matter the quantity of that item, but 4 items, then it puts the list right here on the label, which is handy.
So that's the package ready to go. And is there any other steps? No.
Lift weights with it. It's a heavy one.
So the last step is going over to the post office and dropping the package off along with a few others that we have. And thank you again to Andrea who let us film this entire packaging process. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, please subscribe. And until the next video, keep smiling, keep being awesome, and keep making beautiful things. And we will see you in the next one.
Thanks for joining.
Bye guys.